The first thing we're going to do is build a calculation using Visual Basic and the ACE Wizard add-in. So I'm going to select Add-ins, Pi ACE Wizard, and New. I'm going to put this under My ACE Calcs. That's the executable we started earlier. And I'm going to call this CDT underscore on spec. That's going to be the actual calculation name that we're going to use. And we're going to get to where we declare the inputs and outputs. Well, if you remember, the output alias is going to be the tag that we created called CDT output. So I will do a search for all my tags to start with CDT, and there's my CDT output log tag. That's going to be my output alias, and you'll notice the current value is point created. Now my input alias gets a little bit trickier because I want to use that alias, not the specific tag name. Because remember, if I use a specific tag name here, I have to build the equation four times, one for each tag. I don't want to do that. I want to automate it and make it generic and use one calculation for four contexts. So I'm going to go up into the top bar here and click on the search menu here. And I'm going to pick one of the contexts that I want to use. In this case, it's site one, unit one. And within that site one, unit one, I can then do an alias search, or if I know what the alias is, I can simply type it in here. And you'll notice that when I type in the alias name of flow, I can validate that I've got a correct alias because the current value comes into the equation as well. If it stayed blank or there was some other message there, I would know I'd have to do a different sort of alias here, or again, remember, you can use the alias search as well. I could search for an asterisk under that context, and it would show me all of the aliases that would be available. So once I get my input aliases set and my output aliases set, I can click Finish. Remember, I'm only going to have one output log tag, and that's going to track all of my flow calculations. Once we've defined the name for our calculation, we need to enter in the calculation syntax itself into the code window of Visual Basic. And in this case, I'm going to come down under actual performance equations. That's where my cursor is set automatically. And what I want to do is compare my flow alias to a certain value and write a corresponding message into the log. I'm going to use the value of 50. Because that's right around where the normal tag ranges are. You can see in my current values plugin, most of my values are between about 55 and 80 something. And that's just current, they do vary. So I'll go into my calculation and I'll say if flow.value is greater than 50, then I want to make CDT output logs value equal to flow tag. That's the name of the tag. And I want it equal to the tag name concatenated with the string is normal. If it's not, then I want to make the CDT output logs value equal to the tag name, flow.tag, and the string is under range. And I need to end the logic. And what this will give me is a value written to my CDT output log based on the comparison of its value to the benchmark of 50. And some people ask, why do you use the tag name in the message that you're writing? Well, if you were only using one tag name or one tag in your equation, then you really wouldn't need to because you know what it was referencing. However, remember, we want to use this alias to do many comparisons, and so I need the message to indicate which tag the result of the calculation refers to. So I can complete my code, and I'm ready for testing. Once we've defined our code, we can go and test, and if you click Add-ins, PyAceWizard, and Test, it's going to ask you which module you want to test. Now you're going to get an error here, and that's a very common error, and it's something we need to talk about, permission denied. What that means is that we can't modify the executable because it's running. So what you need to do is go into your ACE manager, and you'll notice that it did pick up my new calculation. However, the executable itself is running, and it will not allow me to modify or do anything to that executable while it is in operation. So I need to stop that by either right-clicking and saying take out of service, or clicking on the button at the top says that take the executable out of service. And once the executable is out of service, then we can go back in, and we should successfully be able to run a test against this module without getting the permission denied error presented to us. We must test the calculation before we actually register it. So let's go into our PyAceWizard and test to make sure we have the proper executable and module name selected. And once we get the variables displayed for the input and output aliases, we can go ahead and test. You'll notice that the tag name's current value, or I'm sorry, the tag name is the alias name. That current value is displayed here. We can click Get Current Values if we want that to be updated. And we can click on Calculate Now. And if our code is correct, we will get a message here under our current value. And you can see that we do. We said CDT158 is normal. And if you want to, you could do some advanced testing. You could change the context if you had more than one defined. We haven't yet. We haven't defined more than one context, but we could. And but at this point in time, I'm good by evaluating current value against 50 and getting a correct output. So I'm going to close the test and proceed to my registering. I will click on PyAceWizard and register. Remember, there's always the debug option if you want to debug your code, if it's complex or there's an error and you want to try to figure it out. Because my test worked fine, I'm going to jump right to register. I'm going to make this a normal priority, and I'm going to make this calculation run based on the clock, and I'm going to run it with a zero offset, and the period is going to be 60 seconds or 1 minute. You could select either one you wanted. And I'm going to click OK, and my unit 1 will have been registered successfully. Once we've registered the calculation, we can change to the ACE manager, and we can restart our executable. That will restart not only our calculations, but any calculations that had occurred with that. And we'll give it a few moments to complete the starting. And there it started. And once it started, we can see that we have one context running. The context is based on a clock scheduling with a period of 60 seconds and an offset of 0. And you'll notice that it is on. So we should be able to go to any of our client tools or anything that will show us a value for a given tag. We should be able to go and to see what the current value for that tag is. Now I'm going to use my data plugin in the SMT, the current values. And I'm going to use that in order to look at the value of the tag. And I can see that the value did run on the minute, and the value is CDT158 is normal. So we've successfully completed the first step in creating an ACE calculation that will use aliases from the module database. Now we can turn our attention to using the module database to propagate our calculation across various structures. And remember, we have 4 units in our context module database, and all those units have the flow alias. So I'm going to use the PyAce manager, and I'm going to right-click on my module and select Add New Context. Now the context I'm going to add will be a similar drill down to what we had earlier. I'll use unit 2 in this example. The priority will continue to be normal. And I'm going to use the same period for my calculation. I'm going to use 60 seconds. But in this case, I'm going to offset it by 15 because I want to be able to determine if the calculations are happening independently. If I use the same offset, one could conceivably replace the other one almost instantaneously, and I wouldn't see it. So what I want to do is use a slightly different offset for my unit 2, and I can click Save. And what you'll see is I've got a unit number 2 here. Its current status is off, and if we wait a few moments and refresh, we can see that it will change to on, and we should have two calculations going. Let's go back to our current values plugin, and remember that the calculation was being run on the minute and then at 15 seconds after the minute. So we'll give this a few moments to run and see if we can get a response. We can see that on the minute we have CDT158 is normal, and we'll see if we can get one at 15 seconds after the minute. There, we've just clicked over on 1104, and if we give this a few more seconds, we should see at 1104 and 15 seconds that the CDT258 is normal, and there we see it. So if we were to continue watching this, we would see every 0 and 15 seconds after the hour, after the minute, that the calculation would be performed. Now, if your calculations don't start immediately, or if there's some delay and you feel like they should be running, you may have to go into your ACE manager and simply stop your executable and restart it. Very often that will get it to pick it up immediately, and instead of waiting for things to synchronize. I've taken the liberty of adding the remaining units to the context of our CDT on spec calc. And if you notice, we have in the current values plugin in the system manager tools, if you watch the results, you will see for the CDT output log tag that we will see at on the minute and 15, 30, and 45 seconds points at each minute, we will evaluate that tag and determine whether that information is normal or under range. And you can see that as we've been talking, every 15 seconds we have reported a value through ACE to this tag.